Hello students and welcome back. This is Swati and today I will be covering English Literature's Unit 10 chapter The Ship of the Desert. This chapter is all about two animals, a lion and a camel, and their conversation. So let's find out what is there in their conversation. Lion, roaring. Who are you? So the lion is roaring and asking the camel, who are you? Now the camel looking down at the lion. As the camel is the tallest animal, the camel is looking down at the lion to answer. I am the ship of the desert. Who are you? Now, the camel has told that I am the ship of the desert, but who are you? The camel asks. Lion, don't you know me? I am the king of the forest. So, the lion has also answered in the same way. As the camel told that I am the ship of the desert, the lion answers that I am the king of the forest. Camel, are you? Oh, I see. So this is the answer of camel. Oh, so you are known as the king of the forest? Like in a surprising way. Are you? Oh, I see. So the lion gets frowning. Frowning means getting angry. And the lion says, you call yourself the ship of the desert. How can you be a ship? You are an animal. So the lion is angry now and answers that you the answers and asks a question also. The lion says that you call the camel, you are calling yourself the ship of the desert, but how can you be a ship? You are an animal. So how can an animal be called a ship? This is the question of the lion. So lion is getting really angry, but the camel is smiling. Camel smiling. So I am, but people call me the ship of the desert. So the camel is very calm and composed and answering lion's questions. The lion asks the camel that how you are called as a ship because you are an animal, to which the camel answers that yes, I am an animal, but people call me the ship of the desert because I can walk across the desert even on a hot afternoon. The camel can walk across the burning sand. The sand burns, but it does not bother me. This is the quality of the camel. This is the speciality of the camel, that the camel can walk on the burning sand in the deserts in the hot afternoon. Lion, I can't believe it. So lion is not believing the same. Camel, can you walk across a desert? Now the camel asks the lion that can you walk across a desert? Lion blinking eyes. No, I can't, but I can run in the forest. So now the lion is telling about lion's speciality, that no, I can't walk on the desert, but I can run in the forest. That's my area. I can run in the forest. Camel with disdain. Every animal can do that. Now the camel has answered that every animal can run in the forest. That's not a speciality. The camel is saying that every animal can do that. Every animal can run in the forest. But I alone can run on the sand. I can run on sand at 25 kilometers an hour. Camel has told about his speciality, that I alone can run on the sand. And I can run on sand at 25 kilometers an hour. That's the speed. That's the great speed for running on the hot sand. So this is the quality of the camel which has been told here. Lion, wonderingly, how can you do that? So now the lion is wondering, how camel you can walk in sand at 25 kilometers an hour speed? That's really great. So lion is wondering about it. How can you do that? Camel, look at my feet. They are thick and padded. The hot sun does not burn them. So now the camel is explaining the reason why the camel is able to walk on burning sand. The feet of the camel are thick and padded, and the hot sun does not burn them. That's why it becomes easy for the camel to walk on burning sand. To which the lion says, my feet are padded too. Thorns don't prick them, and I can run 80 kilometers an hour. So the lion's feet are also padded. So the lion answered the same, that my feet are also padded and thorns don't prick them. And I can also run in the forest for 80 kilometers an hour. Camel, that is true. You can run 80 kilometers an hour in forest, but can you run even a mile on the hot sand? Again, there is a question from camel to the lion, that I know, I agree, that's true that you can run 80 kilometers an hour in forest, but I'm talking about the sand. Can you run even a mile on hot sand? Lion says, maybe not, but So the lion has not completed the sentence, the camel interrupts in between. And you can't live without water for a week, can you? The camel is asking again another question now to the lion, that you can't live without water for a week, can you? Can you live without water? So now the lion says, no, I can't. The lion answers that, no, I can't. I need water every day. But don't tell me you can do without water. So now the lion is answering that I need water every day, but also at the same time asking a question to camel that, don't tell me that you can do without water. Please do not say this. I will not believe it that you can do without water. To which the camel answers, yes, I can. There are no rivers or lakes in a desert. But that does not bother me. I can drink 200 bottles of water at a time. So this is another speciality of the camel here, that because students, there are no rivers or lakes in the desert. There is very less water available in the desert areas. And there is really, it is really hot. And the weather is really hot. The sun is shining. The sun is always shining brightly in the deserted areas. There are no plants available and there is no water available. So, and then too, the camel can survive without water for a long time. And at the single time, the camel can drink 200 bottles of water. So this is what the camel has answered, that I can survive water because there are no rivers or lakes in the desert. But that does not bother me, because what the camel does, the camel drinks 200 bottles of water at a single time. So then the camel stores that water, and that does not bother him later on whether the water is available or not. So after hearing from camel that a camel can drink 200 bottles of water at a time, the lion replies, really? You must have a big stomach, because an animal having a big stomach can only drink that much of water. To which the camel proudly says, yes, I have a big stomach. I can store water for a week. I can store food for 2 weeks even. So now the camel is telling about the qualities, that the food can be stored for 2 weeks and the water can be stored for a week. So now the lion has become curious and showing a lot of interest and asking the camel, do you store food in your stomach? Because the lion wants to know where exactly that much of food is stored. To which the camel says, no, I don't. I store it in my hump. Hump is on the back of the camel and all the food is stored in the hump of the camel. I eat a lot of food at one time. Then I don't need to eat for a fortnight. So a camel eats a lot of food at a single time, and there is no need to eat food for 15 days. Because the food eaten by camel gets stored in the hump of the camel. Lion, that's interesting. But what do you eat? Now the lion finds this thing really interesting. But the lion further wants to know that what is the food of the camel? What does the camel eat? Camel, I eat leaves. But there are no trees in a desert. Lion, what do you eat there? So now the camel told the lion that camel like to eat leaves. But there are no trees in the desert. Desert is not having any trees except the thorny bushes. So now the camel says, there are thorny bushes in the desert. I eat the thorns. The thorns don't prick my thick tongue. So the camel eats the thorns. What are thorns? Thorns are stiff, sharp, woody projections of a plant. But they are so stiff, but still the camel's tongue is so thick that it does not prick on thick tongue of camel. Lion, how funny. So the lion is finding this thing really funny. To which the camel says, Mr. King of the Forest, please come with me to the desert. So the camel is now inviting lion to come to the desert. As the lion is finding this thing really funny, so the camel says, okay, so Mr. King of the Forest, Mr. Lion, please come with me to the desert. I am inviting you to the desert. So the lion says, no, I would better not. I can't walk on the burning sand. I can't store food and water. And I can't eat thorns. Goodbye and good luck, Mr. Ship of the Desert. So now the lion is not finding it funny now. And also the lion now understood that how the camel's life is so difficult in the desert. But still the camel is doing everything. and the alliance knows now that he would not be able to do that much in the, he would not be able to survive in the desert. So the lion says, no, I would not, better not go to the desert, because I cannot walk on the burning sand, I cannot store food and water like the camel does, and I cannot eat the thorns like the camel does. So the lion says, goodbye and good luck, Mr. Ship of the Desert. Now the lion has understood why the camel is known as the Ship of the Desert. So this is the end of the chapter, students. So the words which we have, new words which we have learnt in this chapter are disdain, which is the feeling of something not good enough to be respected. Sand is very fine particles of rocks. And thorns means stiff, sharp, woody projections of a plant. In case you have any doubts related to the same, you can let me know. Thank you.